Gold Association to compulsory merge the Indian Bullion Jeweler Association. In 1948, at the behest of RBI, IBSA was constituted as association and guaranteed company. Sir, we are proud to inform that Mr. S. L. N. Sima was the first director nominated by RBI on our board. Back in 1962, the Gold Control Act marked the end of traditional forward trading in India. The bullion ring, the marketplace of IBSA, fell silent in the government policies and laws. Everything was at a standstill in 1964. The heritage structure of IBSA was sold to Bank of India. The refinery building, which is now transformed into IBSA corporate office, was the only memory left to review the past glory of the association. At such a state, IBSA was barely surviving and standing on its old clutches the decades. The association was in a pitiful state for a brief period. The year 2012 witnessed a bright ray of hope and opportunities for the growth of the association as Mohitji came in power as the president. Firstly, the association building was revamped with world-class interior and design, along with the glass facade giving in a renewed appearance. The corporate office was revamped with a presentable reception, well-furnished boardroom, cabins, members' lounge, and workstations matching international standards. Under this leadership, the association soared to new heights. Today, IBSA is widely recognized as the apex body of gems and jewelry sector in this country. Mohitji included qualified professionals in Team IBSA. He also appointed few consultants who were expert in the field of customs, DGFT, taxes, indirect taxes, legal and banking, etc. Slowly and gradually, the results were seen. IBSA meeting, board meeting, and general meeting were held in the most professional manner. As a result of Mohitji's professional approaches, IBSA participated in various conferences and seminars relating to the gems and jewelry industries, gaining tremendous appreciation and recognition. The Bombay Bullion Association was the apex and oldest body in India, but its presence was restricted to Mumbai and Maharashtra only. It was very important for the association to spread its wings and extend into boundaries to have its reach and presence move throughout India, thereby taking at a national as well as international level. For this, I was essentially to change the name of the association first. Hence, India Bullion and Jeweler Association Limited, then with the 100% majority, was passed. This transformation of association name from Bombay Bullion Association to India Bullion Jeweler Association had provoked interest from across the country. The vision of our young and dynamic president accelerated the path of growth and success, with various changes into the organization and multiple initiatives added to the core activities. The changes of the name definitely boosted the growth and fame of our association. One of these growth strategies is the Pan India expansion. We have started off with membership drive across India, inviting individuals and organizations to join IBSA by way of gold membership of IBSA. Our aim is to take 1 lakh members across the country and make IBSA the national canopy for the entire gems and jewelry fraternity. IBSA has also started working at Pan India level. Our president started handling issue and problem across India and at the same time addresses the government through IBSA. In September 2012, our president had presented a foolproof method to Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji to assist to end the current account deficit of the country by introducing gold monetization scheme. Modi ji even appreciated the idea of gold monetization scheme and assured our IBSA delegation that the gold monetization scheme will be launched whenever his government comes to power. Today, IBSA is a part of the gold monetization scheme committee in Government of India and actively working on delivering the implementation mechanism of the same. Business and entertainment combined to create India's first ever India International Bullion Summit. The idea behind organizing IIBS was to create awareness to issue not only from the members but also of the community at large. This summit gives a platform to the industry to keep abreast of the latest development and opportunity in the field of mining, banking, insurance, logistics, etc. related to the gems and jewelry industry. This is also a worthy platform to put one's suggestion and grievance to various regulators. This event brings together a diversified group of experts, officers and trade pundits not only in India but across the world. Second, ITRA Award and Fashion Show. The India Bullion Jeweler Association Award celebrates and honors the top corporates and individuals for their outstanding contribution to our trade and industry. The ITRA Fashion Show is marked and glitz and glamour fashion collided with business and glamour has added the finest creation of jewelers from the industry. The initiative of this glamorous event was to get the best artwork from industry in the limelight and promote the manufacturers, retailers and wholesalers. ITRA Awards are conducted in conjunction with the ITRA Fashion Show and live performance to make it an unforgettable evening. ITRA Publication. We publish monthly magazine and daily newsletter that updates about the current affairs and policies related to the industries. Fourth, ITRA Jewelry and Knowledge Park. We are in the process to set up a ITRA Jewelry and Knowledge Park, the first ever in the country, in an area measuring 500 acres, which will have a dedicated zone for manufacturing and related activity on 300 acres. Amenities and support activities including training, institutes, research center, exhibition and convention center, residences, hostels, schools and hospitals, among other, will be set up on the balance 200 acres. 5. ITRA has formally launched the logo of Make in India, initiative for the gems and jewelry sector and making Maharashtra initiative. 6. World Silver Council is a market development organization for the silver industry, which will be working within the investment, jewelry and technology sector, as well as engaging in government affairs. It purpose to be provide industry leadership while stimulating and sustaining the demand for silver. The World Silver Council was launched on December 26, 2015 by H.E. Ramnathan Kovindji, Governor of Bihar at Sofitel Hotel, Mumbai, with the prime purpose of setting purity standards of silver. 7. ITRA Skill Development Council. Growing to the pinnacles of being the apex body of bullion trade in India, ITRA has worked for pan-India operations and is actively progressing towards skill development. IBJAL Skill Council is formed with the sole purpose of enhancing skill development and improving job opportunities, thereby generating business prospects in the gems and jewelry industry. 8. First Step Foundation. As a 97 years old association, we consider social responsibility highly important not only towards our members but also towards our workers, staff and society as a whole. First Step Foundation is one such initiative by ITRA which serves for the betterment of the society and its grassroots level. 9. ITRA Gold. ITRA Gold is a brainchild of our President Mohit Kamboj, which aims at opening retail showrooms exclusively for gold coin that will have ITRA's own branded monogram on all gold coins. ITRA Jewels. ITRA Jewels is an online portal, a marketplace for jewelers, matching the changing trend of the consumer and the retail industry on whole. This initiative was the need of our, and ITRA leaves no stone unturned for the upliftment of our industry. ITRA Bullion Exchange. ITRA and Bombay Stock Exchange has signed a memorandum of understanding to set up India's first physical bullion exchange in the country. The idea of setting up a bullion exchange in the country was triggered by Mr. Shaktikanta Das, Secretary Department of Economy Affairs, Ministry of Finance, at the 3rd India International Summit 2015. India import about 1,000 tons of gold every year, which is equivalent to 250,000 crores. However, the government at the present is unable to locate utilization and consumption of imported gold in the country, as most of such transactions are not recorded officially. Bullion exchange will be a single platform between buyer and seller of bullion and jewelry, which will bring complete transparency in the trade. The proposed bullion exchange plans to rope in designated bullion banks for the delivery of bullion, which will be the first spot exchange platform gathering all banks, bullion, merchant dealers, exporters, refiners, wholesalers, retailers, nominated agency, gold mutual funds, etc. can transact and transact the trade apart for the ultimate consumer. Once the GST is in place, this spot exchange will enable buying and delivery of goods all over the country at one price. Besides being the apex association for gems and jewelry sector in India, IBDA is the only association which has an active participant in Digital India initiative of the Government of India. IBDA operates its own official website www.ibja.co with the motive to have an easy access to the association information and latest updates and current affairs of the industry. Daily updates of India AMPM rates also declare on our website www.ibjarates.com. We have also launched 12 independent websites for all our events and initiatives. We also have 2 fully functioning mobile apps and 6 social media channels. Our future plan is to launch IBDA Refinery and IBDA Exhibition soon. This was a small recap of the past glorious year of this association, and after Mohit Kamboj came into power as the president. While 1998 to 2012 is a book which reveals many interesting facts, history and past glories of the association, 1050 days is a book that covers all the events, activities and achievement of the association from 2012 to 2015. I hope you all will enjoy reading the books as much as we did during their creation. Once again, I would like to extend my sincere appreciation to Sri S.S. Mundra ji, Sri Ashish Shailar ji, Sri Ashish Chauhan ji, PM Somsundar ji, Mehul Choksi for their presence as the chief guests, and all the distinguished guests and IBDA members for joining us at this occasion. Thank you. Have a wonderful evening.